गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरावन चारी यमुना तीरावन चारी यमुना तीरावन चारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरावन चारी यमुना तीरावन चारी यमुना तीरावन चारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी 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 जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिवराज कचार्य अष्टोतरशत श्री श्रीमद् हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिवराज कचार्य अष्टोतरशत श्री श्रीमद् हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवास आदि गौर भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जय। ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। श्री नवद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय। पुरुषोत्तम क्षेत्र श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। गंगा माई जमुना माई की जय। तुलसी देवी भक्ति देवी की जय। श्री हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज। ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्री गुरु एंड श्री गौरांग। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नष्ट प्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। टेक्स्ट हरे कृष्णा। सो वी रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 11 टेक्स्ट नंबर 22। बन्धुनां नष्ट गोत्राणां अर्जुनः सांपरायिकं हतानां कारयाम् आस यथा वद अनुपूर्वशः बंधुनाम नष्ट गोत्राणाम अर्जुन सांपरायकम् हतानां कारयामास यथावदनुपूर्वशः बंधुनाम नष्ट गोत्राणाम् अर्जुन सांपरायकम् हतानां कारयामास यथावद् अनुपूर्वशः बंधुनाम नष्ट गोत्राणाम् अर्जुन सांपरायकम् हतानां कारयामास यथावद् अनुपूर्वशः बंधुनाम ऑफ द रिलेटिव्स नष्ट गोत्राणाम हु हैड नो रिमेनिंग इमीडिएट फैमिली मेंबर्स अर्जुनः अर्जुन सांपरायिकम द फ्यूनरल राइट्स हतानाम ऑफ द किल्ड कारयामास had executed yathavat as prescribed in the Vedas anupurvashah in order of the seniority of the deceased translation by the disciples of His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Arjuna then saw to it that the funeral rites were properly carried out for the dead who had no remaining male family members He executed the required ceremonies for each of the Yadus, one after another. It has no purpose, so we read next verse. Dvarkam harina tyaktam samudro plavayat kshanat Varjaitva maharaja shrimad bhagavat halayam Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada. As soon as Dwarka was abandoned by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the ocean flooded it on all sides, O King, sparing only His palace. Srila Jiva Goswami explains that whereas the external manifestation of the Lord's abode was covered by the ocean, the Lord's eternal Dwarka exists beyond the material universe and certainly beyond the material ocean. Dwarka had been constructed by Vishwakarma, the architect of the demigods, and the Sudharma assembly hall had been brought from heaven. In that city, there were many beautiful and splendorous residences of the aristocratic Yadu dynasty, and the most beautiful residence of all was that of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Srila Jiva Goswami mentions that even in the modern age, people who live near the site of the original Dwarka sometimes catch a glimpse of it in the ocean. Ultimately, the Lord's associates and abode are eternal, and one who understands this is qualified to become fully Krishna conscious. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणा ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्णकरुणा सिन्धु दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा। सो द यदु डायनेस्टी इज अबाउट टू डिसअपियर और हैज डिसअपियर्ड नॉट कंप्लीटली बिकॉज कृष्णा आइडेंटिफाइज हिमसेल्फ विद द यदु डायनेस्टी सो ही स्टिल देयर। सो here it is explained that when all the male members fought among themselves, they destroyed each other. It was the arrangement of the Lord. When people do not understand this particular pastime of the Lord from the right sources, so they misunderstand. And that is what happens in Kali Yuga mostly, because people try to understand the leelas of the Lord, the truth behind his pastimes, with their own minds. And as the Bhagavad Gita explains, even our intelligence, our faith, determination, everything falls under the control of the three gunas. That means whatever little intelligence we have, the faith, determination, everything, likes, dislikes, it is based on whatever gunas we have acquired from the past lives, and that varies from individual to individual. Depending on whatever we deserve, that much intelligence is given. Hence, scriptures must not be understood simply based on our own intelligence. They have to be understood from the right authorities. Because scriptures are revealed, they are not understood simply because a person knows English, Sanskrit or Hindi. Therefore, the importance of a guru is very important in one's life, and guru also somebody who is bona fide, coming in the bona fide disciplic succession. So some people may go to other gurus who are not a part of disciplic succession, and they will also talk from Gita, Bhagavad, but they will not get the correct understanding about God. They may also speak. Correct understanding is only available in the four bona fide sampradayas which the Lord has authorized to distribute knowledge about him: the Brahma Sampradaya, Rudra Sampradaya, Shri Sampradaya and Kumara Sampradaya. Others may go on speaking, but the correct understanding will not come. So people misunderstand Krishna's pastimes, and somehow their source of information, especially in Kali Yuga, has become social media, Google, WhatsApp. So anything they read on WhatsApp also, they think it is the absolute truth. And if you ask them, they come up with some, there are many authors also writing books, creating controversies deliberately around Krishna, Ram, because they know that's what sells. And somebody is deliberately doing that also. So this way people will never understand, and somehow they spread the message and they subtly try to demean God. They will talk about Krishna, some Leela, Dwarka Leela, and just like Harold Kushner, who wrote that book, When Bad Things Happen to Good People. So he was a rabbi, a Christian priest. At the age of 7, his only child got progeria. That means he started aging prematurely, his teeth started falling off, bones became brittle, hair turned grey, skin became wrinkled. At the age of 11, he looked like a 60-year-old man and died. So all his life he had been preaching about God. Now he was very angry with God. Why did he let my child die? Because he did not have the understanding about the law of karma. Now he wanted to defy God's existence, but he could not do it openly, because he had been preaching about God throughout his life. So he wrote a book, When Bad Things Happen to Good People, in which he very subtly put God down. He says, oh, God is all merciful and all powerful, but he may not be all knowing. Because if he was all knowing, he would have known my child was innocent. He would have saved him. He may be all knowing and all powerful, but he is not all merciful. Otherwise, he would have shown mercy upon my child. He may be all merciful and all knowing, but not all powerful. Otherwise, he would have saved my child. So, subtly, he just demeaned God, let people know. He was not even directly abusing God, blaspheming God, but he subtly did it with his word jugglery, letting people know God is not perfect. Give him benefit of doubt. So people get doubts. So that's what is happening. So therefore, the process of acquiring knowledge, Krishna explains in the fourth chapter, Tadviddhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tattva darshinah. One must approach a bona fide guru, inquire from him submissively, and then render service unto him, because when we render service, the knowledge that we receive gets digested. Without that service, knowledge may not be digested. It may cause indigestion also. Menial service, specifically. So Krishna's Dwarka Leela, why he made the Yadus disappear in a particular way? Krishna speaks, Tattva must be understood. Anybody who can understand the Tattva, this purport also mentions, he does not have to take any more material worth in this world. Simply by understanding, Janma Karma Cha Me Divyam Evam Yuveti Tattvataha Tyaktva Deham Punar Janma Naiti Ma Meti Su Arjuna. So liberation or mukti is not such a cheap thing that yogis strive for lifetimes, perform austerities. But Krishna says that anybody who can understand the truth behind his appearance and activities is easily liberated. So it goes to show that performing tapasya for thousands of years, controlling mind and senses, is easier than understanding Krishna, the tattva behind his leela. Because yogis try hard so that they can be liberated, but it's difficult. They fail also. But here, simply by understanding the leelas of Krishna, the tattva behind, the truth behind his appearance and activities, one gets liberated. So understanding Krishna is more difficult than performing the most severe tapasyas. So, and there are people who are trying to understand him through WhatsApp, Google, social media, and any message that makes rounds on social media, they think this is true. Kahan padha hai aapne? Sometimes people come up with some weird questions. So you ask, where did you find it? It was on the WhatsApp. Received a forward on WhatsApp. Or it is in Wikipedia, it's on Google. So this is the symptom of Kali Yuga. Because if Kali Yuga has to progress, then it has to destroy people's dharma. It has to destroy people's faith in God. Essentially, faith in scriptures. So there are many such agents working in different ways. Because if people have faith in scriptures, if people have Krishna, then Kali Yuga cannot progress. So Kali Yuga is also trying hard. It's his yuga. So somehow Krishna's creation is so special that he has created so many things, some strange things also. And he has a purpose behind it. Like when Ekadashi entered this world, Krishna made that arrangement. Narad Muni was really worried about the people of Kali Yuga. There is a lot of suffering. So Ekadashi entered, Ekadashi Devi. So Papa personified, Papa Purusha approached Lord Vishnu. He said, what have you done? He said, Ekadashi has come and you have rendered me jobless. Because people will observe Ekadashi, they'll get purified of all the sins. Mere liye to kuch kaam hi nahi bacha. You have created me also, give me also some work. And Krishna was thinking how to resolve the issue because you cannot allow him to just move around freely. So he said, all right, on Ekadashi you can reside within the grains. So he tricked him. So on Ekadashi, it was understood, I think even the Lord did not think that people will eat grains in future on Ekadashi. So he said, and he knew that on Ekadashi nobody would eat, nobody would do sense gratification. So he thought, all right, you reside within the grains on Ekadashi. So people will not eat grains, so you will not get affected by papa. So he has created some things which are not easy to understand, Krishna's leelas. And therefore the most wonderful leela of all the leelas that Krishna performs is his leela as a human being. When he comes, he exactly acts like a human being. He is born to parents, then he grows up, he sleeps, he eats, he acts like a human being, like Lord Ramchandra, as a human being. He did not exhibit his divinity as Krishna also on very few occasions. Otherwise, he was dependent on Yashoda Mai playing with his friends. When he was in Dwarka, he would regularly visit Hastinapur. Whenever he would visit Hastinapur, he would touch Yudhishthir Maharaj and Bhim's lotus feet because they were elder to him. He would touch Kunti's feet. Yudhishthir would call for him, immediately Krishna would come. When he was to perform the Rajasvi Yagya, he wanted to consult Krishna. The messenger came, and with the messenger only Krishna came. He did not even wait. He is not bound by anybody's orders, but he came. So it is the Lord's Leela when he wants to take his family back to the spiritual world, Yadus, who are his eternal family. Then he has to do something by which there is some wholesale killing happens externally. Because most of these Yadus were devatas. They had appeared with the Lord to assist him in his mission. And now the Lord decided to end his mission. So he had to go. So he had to do something by which it seemed to be humanly possible. And in the process he bewildered the atheists also. So he got himself shot by an arrow. So because he considers himself a part of Yadu dynasty, so that the curse was there. So that arrow was made of that same element which was supposed to destroy the Yadu dynasty. So he acts like human beings, but he says, Janma karma cha me divyam. My activities and my appearance, they are all divya, they are not mundane. Anybody who can understand does not have to take any more material birth. So as far as the Brajavasis were concerned, he did not made them fight. The warriors are supposed to fight. So he made them fight amongst each other because nobody else could destroy the Yaduvanshis. They were so powerful. So he had to make them fight, and Krishna Balaram personally got involved in that fight. And that's how, after they were killed, the Yadus, they went back to the heavens and they were reinstated in their positions as demigods. So he had to end their leela, he had to end his leela also. So it is very, very important therefore to understand from the Acharya's point of view. Otherwise we have limited intelligence and we end up imposing our own consciousness on the Lord's pastimes. Here it is explained, Arjuna performed the final rites according to the Vedic injunctions. And the final rites, unless they are performed according to Vedic injunctions, the soul may get stuck. There is an incident I heard, Hanuman Prasad Poddarji, he was the first editor of Gita Press, they have done such tremendous service to humanity. And he translated, literally, he edited all the books of Gita Press. He was the first of all. And it is believed that he was a very, very advanced devotee, Vaishnava. At the same time, he was a businessman also. He stayed in Bombay only, Marine Drive. So he would come back in the evening. And then he would come to Chowpatty. At that time, it was not crowded. It was similar to what it seems to be today during COVID. Empty. In the evening, he would just sit and chant. And he used to chant he used to chant 40 rounds of Maha Mantra. So one evening he was sitting and chanting. He was walking and then he sat down on a bench chanting. And suddenly he sees one person standing in front of him. And this person is looking at him, he's not speaking anything. Then finally he said, "Say, who are you? Do you want to say something? Please speak up." This person said, "I can speak, but I hope you will not get scared." He said, no, you say whatever you want to say. See, he said, "I am a ghost." "I am a ghost." He said, "We are not allowed to even speak. We can't eat, we can't sleep. We are in a particular subtle body that we have to suffer. But just by seeing you, a lot of my sins got destroyed. So at least I am able to speak to you now. Just by darshan, as the acharyas have sung, darshane pavitra kari ei tomar gun. So simply by seeing a Vaishnava, a person's sinful reactions are destroyed to a great extent. And to the degree the Vaishnava is elevated, to that very degree the sinful reactions are destroyed. He said, "So I'm able to at least speak, otherwise we can't even speak to anyone. And please help me." So he said, "What help do you need?" He said, so he mentioned a particular community he belonged to. And he said, "I'm from this community and please can you send somebody to Gaya and do my final rites, do my shraddha. Because unless that is done, I am stuck, I am suffering." So Hanuman Prasad Poddarji was surprised. He said, "You have not been delivered? In your community you have a system of how they treat the dead body and that's what they believe in. So why didn't you get liberated? Why didn't you get elevated? Why are you stuck?" He said, "Ye sab idhar ka banaya hua manodharma hai. This is all made up thing." Said, once the person dies, the soul is treated as per the Vedic injunctions, as per the Vedic rites. People have made up certain things, you cremate the body this way, you do this way, that way. But ultimately, it's all made up by people. Ultimately, it's the Vedic scriptures which are the ultimate truth. And once the person dies, if he's not cremated, if he's not, the soul is not served the way it is mentioned in the scriptures, the soul is stuck, whatever you may do. So clearly it is mentioned, Arjuna performed the Vedic rites as prescribed in the Vedas, Yathavat. And further it is mentioned, as soon as Dwarka was abandoned by Krishna, because Krishna had told, when Krishna was about to depart, he sat under that tree with a beautiful smile on his face, and Daruk came. Krishna remembered him, and not remembered, Daruk was actually looking for Krishna because he had left Dwarka. Krishna made such an arrangement that his eternal associates, they stayed in Dwarka, and the devatas, they were made to go to Prabhas Kshetra because he couldn't have let his eternal associates fight among themselves. So they disappeared with Krishna from Dwarka directly went back to the spiritual world. But the Yadus who fought among themselves by Krishna's and Balaram's will, they were actually the Devatas. And after that, they were reinstated in their positions. So Krishna also had left. Daruk was looking for his master. And he was in his chariot, Krishna's divine chariot, with his Saranga bow and other weapons also. So at that time, Krishna instructed Daruk, "You please go, because very soon the ocean will take over Dwarka, everything will be gone. So you go and let everybody know in Dwarka that all what has happened to Yaduvanshis, they have disappeared." And Krishna then indicated it was time for him also to end the Leela. And in front of Daruk, the chariot of Krishna just ascended to the spiritual world. So Daruk, with a heavy heart, he went back to Dwarka and informed everyone. And after a few days, the ocean just rose and everything was destroyed. And the eternal associates, they disappeared. Because eternal associates, Krishna takes special care. It is explained that when he came back to Vrindavan also, the Puranas explain, in his chariot he put everything, Yashoda Mai, Nanda Baba, Radharani, everyone, and he took them back to Golok Vrindavan. So only the Devatas who had descended from the heavens, they were the Yadus who fought with those weapons. So essentially we understand, especially talking about the translation and the purport, one point is that as soon as Krishna abandoned Dwarka, it lost its charm, it lost its auspiciousness. Krishna is known as the abode of auspiciousness, Mangal Bhavan Amangal Hari. That Mangal Bhavan means he's the residence of auspiciousness. Auspiciousness, if there is any auspiciousness in the world, it resides within Krishna. He's the abode, he's the source. And Amangal Hari, he takes away all inauspiciousness. When he enters somebody's life, he enters this world, he enters somebody's body, it becomes auspicious. Otherwise, everything is useless. Take for example, when Mahavishnu creates all the universes, he creates the material ingredients, universes, but those material elements are not in action till the time Mahavishnu glances over them. Then they start acting and everything starts manifesting. We talk about our own body. Krishna explains, Mame Vansho Jiva Loke Jiva Bhutaha Sanatanaha. So the souls are parts and parcels of Krishna. This body is matter. And as long as that part and parcel of Krishna, the soul, resides within the body looks beautiful, the body grows, the body is attractive. As soon as Krishna element in the form of the soul, Krishna's part and parcel leaves the body, body does not grow, body cannot move, it cannot act, and you just leave it, starts disintegrating within 3 days. So only Krishna's presence makes this body auspicious. Whether you talk about the creation, everything is Krishna in the sense that everything is his energy. And unless he enters that energy, it is difficult to get that auspiciousness, to get that satisfaction. Our life also. Our life is auspicious as long as Krishna is present. Otherwise, it is inauspicious. Food is an ordinary food if Krishna is not present. In the third chapter, he explains, anybody who eats food without offering in sacrifice, that means sacrifice means for the pleasure of Krishna, Yageshwara. So he's verily eating sin. It is filled with karma. So everything has value as long as Krishna is present. As soon as Krishna leaves, all inauspicious things start happening. Krishna bhuliya jiva bhogavancha kare nikatastha maya tare chapatiya tare. Mayadevi is always standing next to Krishna. She's like Krishna's shadow. It's not that she's far away. Even when we are under Krishna's shelter, Mayadevi is still next to him. It's not that we have gone away from Maya, just that Krishna protects us from Maya. Vyasadev could see Maya Devi standing behind Krishna. She's like Krishna's shadow, Krishna's Shakti. And as soon as a person desires to live a life independent of Krishna, he says, I don't want God in my life. He develops that kind of desire. And as long as he desires like that, first of all, as soon as he develops a desire, I also want to live separately from God. Nikatastha Maya Tare Jhapatiya Dhare. Immediately Maya Devi catches him and the person comes under the laws of karma, action and reaction. Because Maya Devi's realm is the material world, Durga, Durg. And in the material world, different rules are applicable. So we are used to living in a great opulence. In the spiritual world, we never die. There is constant bliss, knowledge. When we come to the material world, still the same desires remain, but we are in a different country. So the laws of that country will be applicable. And therefore, even though we have certain desires, but we cannot fulfill them, we are made to go through the experience of death. We are made to forget. We are made to suffer. Although we are eternal, we are full of knowledge and full of bliss, free from suffering, being parts and parcels of God. But we are in a different realm. Why are we here? Because we desire to live a life independent of God. So the inauspiciousness for the soul begins when it desires to be independent of Krishna. Nikatastha Maya Tare Jhapatiya Dhare. There is a word called Anath. Anath means somebody who is without a master. And generally people think somebody who is without parents is considered anath. But the scriptural perspective is different. Real master is Krishna. And anybody who does not have Krishna as his shelter is considered anath. And anybody who has Krishna as his master is considered anath. Just like a dog, Prabhupada said, devotee is Krishna's dog. And his kantimala is like that strap a dog has around its neck. So that indicates this dog has a master, so nobody will touch him. So difference between anath and sanath is that one has a master and one does not have a master. And suppose a dog without a master, without a strap, what happens? Everybody is ready to pounce upon him. People throw stones, people ridicule, and he has to run around like a crazy person. But a dog which has a master, he doesn't have to worry. All it needs to do is just be loyal to the master. And then totally protected from all kinds of dangers. And then he becomes fearless also. Bhajahure mana Shri Nandanandan Abhaya Charanarvindare. That if we have shelter of Krishna, then we are fearless. That's the only platform of fearlessness. Like in one lecture, Radha Gopinath Prabhu had mentioned, he saw this incident. Two friends are talking to each other. So one has a puppy, a small dog. One has like something like a bulldog, a German shepherd. And he's like big. This dog is big. And this puppy is small. But this puppy is standing between the legs of his owner and is barking at that bulldog, that German shepherd, or whichever dog it was. It was quite big. So where did it get that strength from? Knowing that there is my master, kuch ho bhi gaya to, dekh lenge. So that assurance is there, I will be protected. And that's the only platform of fearlessness. So when Krishna is there, all the auspiciousness is there. That's what happens between the devatas and the Danavas. Whenever there is a war, apparently the demons also have tremendous powers. Sometimes more powers than the devatas. Hiranyakashipu, Ravana, Kansa. Many of these demons, Hiranyaksha, they had conquered the universe. But there is one factor that makes the difference, all the difference always. The devatas are favored by Krishna and demons are not. So even though they have power, strength, influence, wealth, everything, but they cannot survive, they cannot maintain their power for a long time. However, because devatas are chosen by Krishna and their power, their influence, their positions are by the grace of Krishna, so they are always protected. The other power may be, the other party may be stronger than them, but ultimately they are protected by Krishna because they are cooperating with Krishna's will. They choose to deliberately put themselves under Krishna's care. And this is the only factor which made all the difference in the battle of Kurukshetra. The Kauravas had powerful warriors. Duryodhana himself was no less. Dushasan, Karna, Kripacharya, Bhishma, Drona, Ashwatthama. You name it and they had it. Everything. Bhishma could not be killed. Drona could not be killed easily. Kripacharya, Chiranjeev, Ashwatthama, Chiranjeev. Jayadrath had a strange benediction. So even if somebody killed him, that person would not survive after killing him. So who made that difference in this battle? There was only one factor. Although apparently he was not fighting. He was just sitting, casually caring for the horses, driving the chariot around. But just because he was sitting on the side of the Pandavas were victorious. Jayastu Panduputranam Yesham Pakshe Janardana. Victory will always be with those people who have Krishna on their side, Janardana, who is the real maintainer. And the last verse of the Gita gives the ultimate message. Yatra Yogeshwaro Krishna, Yatra Parthur Dhanurdhara, Tatra Shri Vijayo Bhuti Dhruva Nitir Matir Mama. Wherever there is Krishna and his devotees like Arjuna, in that place there will always be victory, morality and opulence. So people who have Krishna in their life, they might lose certain battles in life, but they will win the ultimate war. And the ultimate war, that is against Maya, against this material world. She is the in charge of the material world. So that means winning the war against Maya, a person, because we are in the material world, it has different laws. So Krishna teaches by his example, by the examples of his devotees, that even if you are my closest people, still the nature of this world is that you have to go through traumas sometimes. In the purport, in first canto, Prabhupada writes very beautiful purport, very beautiful point in that purport. Because many times we think karma is the reason for a person suffering. But that one point changed the whole perspective. So Yudhishthira Maharaj is sinless, ajat shatru. And it was not his plan to engage in that war. Duryodhana insisted. And Krishna's will, because he had to destroy the demons. But after the battle was over, Yudhishthira Maharaj, because he had such soft and gentle and saintly heart, always whenever anything wrong happened around him, he would curse him, he would feel guilty, he would think he was responsible. So even before the battle happened, after the Rajasui Yajna, Vyasadeva was leaving. So Yudhishthira Maharaj told Vyasadeva that during the Rajasui Yajna, I was sitting next to Narad Muni, and Narad Muni told me that he could see three different types of inauspicious signs, terrestrial, atmospheric, and something else, one more he mentioned. So what does it mean? Does it mean that, because after that Shishupal's killing happened, so he said, does it mean that those signs indicated that Shishupal had to be killed and it's over now, the tragedy is over, calamity is over? He said, no, that the calamity has just started with this Rajasui Yajna, and that next 13 years will be a great hardship for all of you. So anything that happens, understand it is Krishna's will. So don't try to retaliate, don't try to feel bad about it. So it was clear, it was Krishna's will of the providence. But still Yudhishthira Maharaj was feeling that it was because of his desire to be the king. The battle happened and so many people died. So many widows, so many orphans he created. So Prabhupada writes in that purport that Yudhishthira Maharaj is sinless. Still he has to go through this trauma, seeing his own family member getting killed, feeling that extreme distress. So he writes that this world is such a place. This world is such a place that even if you are the most pious person, still you might have to go through trauma. The nature of the world is such. So devotees of Krishna, they might lose certain battles in life, but because they have him with them, so they will win the ultimate war. And ultimately, the ultimate war is war against Mayadevi. Mayadevi means this material world. That means we are stuck here. So human life is the best opportunity where we can win that war. But it is very difficult to win that war alone. Devi hi esha gunamai mama maya duratyaya. Only one way. Mame vaya prapadyante maya metam tarantite. Only by surrendering to Krishna. Then we can win this war. Win this war means, as Prabhupada used to say, we can go back home, back to Godhead. We can go beyond the realm of Maya. In the Samudra Manthan, we see so many things came out. And Devatas worked hard, and Danvas also worked equally hard. So many things were coming out. The Lord had cautioned the Devatas not to oppose whatever the demons say. And they also worked equally hard in uprooting that mountain and then doing the churning. So one by one things were coming out. Some things were accepted by the Devatas, some things were taken by the demons. Then Lakshmiji came out. And when Lakshmiji came out, she's glancing at everyone. But ultimately she's only looking for Lord Vishnu to be her husband. There it is mentioned, when Lakshmiji came out, she glanced favorably towards the Devatas. And with that glance, Devatas became recipients of all the good fortune. She is the good fortune. And because the demons were bereft of Mother Lakshmi's glance, they became deprived of all the good fortune then and there itself. So Lakshmiji follows Krishna, her husband, wherever he goes. So wherever there is Krishna, there is good fortune, automatically. And only those people who are favored by Krishna are favored by Lakshmi. That means the goddess of fortune. And therefore, the nature of the world, we cannot change. There will be ups and downs, whether we are a devotee or a non-devotee. But if we have Krishna, then we'll be protected always. The Pandavas were the closest people to Krishna. They were his cousins, they were his devotees, pure devotees. Now, that did not stop the dangers coming to their lives, one after the other. But what is the most important point here to learn is that although so many dangers came, that was the nature of the world. But because Krishna was there, these dangers could not harm them. They were always protected. That is what the process of bhakti assures. It's not that by becoming a devotee, these things will not come into our life, ups and downs, changes, constantly changing material world. But if we have Krishna, we will be protected from that. So many people may be shooting bullets at us. Now, we cannot tell them not to shoot. That's their lookout. That's their choice. But if we are wearing a bulletproof jacket, then we are not hurt. We are not dying. So that's what happens when we have Krishna. As long as he is there, our life is auspicious, and as soon as he leaves, life becomes inauspicious. Everything that Krishna leaves becomes inauspicious. Kali Yuga could not enter as long as Krishna was there. As soon as he left, Yudhishthir Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj, they started seeing all the bad signs in the environment, in the atmosphere. So therefore, it is mentioned when Krishna left Dwaraka, as soon as it was abandoned by Krishna, the ocean took control. As long as Krishna was in Dwaraka, Krishna was in control. So therefore, the best way to maintain auspiciousness in our life is to allow Krishna to take full control, to allow Krishna to enter our life. And the way we can allow Krishna to enter our life, Kali Kale Namarupe Krishna Avatar. The easiest, quickest, safest and surest way by which we can always keep association with Krishna, he's always by our side, is the chanting of Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So this is the surest way, this is the greatest assurance that Krishna is there and all auspiciousness is there. Oma Pavitraha Pavitrova Sarva Vastham Gato Pivaha Yasmaret Pundari Kaksham Sabbahya Abhyantara Shuchihi. As soon as Krishna is remembered, everything becomes auspicious. Even if a person has gone through various situations in life, pure, impure or inauspicious, everything quickly becomes pure and auspicious. As soon as we remember the lotus-eyed Lord Krishna. And the most powerful way is to, or the most powerful way to allow him entry into our life is through his name, through his katha. Name is primary, then his katha, his devotees, his prasad, his remembrance, prayers, nine forms of bhakti. Whichever attracts our heart, we can try to give more time to that, and that will assure that our whole life is auspicious and we are then able to win the ultimate war against Maya. We might lose certain battles, but ultimate victory in the ultimate war is guaranteed. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai.